Ah. Nothing warms my heart more than a December in Youngstown, Ohio. The snow is falling. The semester is coming to an end. And the holidays are upon us. Good evening. My name is Sir Pugsley Cofield Jones, distinguished alumnus, expert of all things Youngstown State University, and in my spare time, close-up magician. But you want to know what's even more magical? This time of the year? As a matter of fact, it was a day just like this when the snow penguin came to life on the campus of Youngstown State University. What a hoot. We laughed, we danced, we got hold of a sled and slid it down the hill to... Wait. You're telling me you've never heard the story of when the snow penguin came to life? Well, we need to change that right now. Let me grab this yearbook. Never heard of the snow penguin. Here we are. It all started a few years ago after the first fall of snow when some students decided to build a snow penguin. But there was something very special about that scarf that they used.
I think it looks great. What should we name it?
What about Pugsley?
No.
What about Kofo?
No.
Well, in my opinion, those are two very good suggestions.
What about Pete?
Yes, that's perfect.
I think it looks great.
With a feeling of pride in their hearts and a lack of feeling in their toes, the students prepared to go back inside until...
Did you guys hear that?
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it myself. There he was, Pete, the snow penguin. Naturally, the students were eager to take Pete around campus and show off their new friend to everyone else. As the day went on, Pete started to get hungry. And while he couldn't get his favorite type of fish on campus, the candy counter was able to provide the next best thing. Swedish fish. Unfortunately for Pete, his discovery of candy also led him to the discovery of cavities. So their next stop was the dental hygiene clinic. After learning a very valuable lesson and scoring some sweet swag, Pete continued his tour and found himself in the football locker room. He had never been so excited in all of the 2 hours and 37 minutes of his entire life. He asked if he could try on one of the helmets, but it wasn't long until Pete realized that he was probably a lot better off volunteering as the mascot than as a football player. Pete even left his mark in the small business development center.
So we need a new logo for this new company, but we want something innovative, something fresh. But what do you guys think? You got any ideas?
You know, everybody's always trying to do something hot. Why don't we try and do something cold?
Perfect.
Like what though? We just need an animal, like we need something.
How about a penguin?
Perfect.
I like it.
Soon, everyone across campus knew that the snow penguin had come to life, and it even made the cover of the jam bar. Even the president asked to meet with the snow penguin himself.
You know, that snow penguin reminds me of someone I work with.
Everyone was having a blast, but the students soon learned that all good things must come to an end. For the unpredictable Northeast Ohio weather was changing, and Pete had to find a colder place to live. After a heartfelt goodbye, Pete promised to return to see all of his friends as he waddled into the sunset. I'm sorry, it's just the end of that story gets me every time. Anyway, they say that if you listen carefully after the first fall of snow, you too can hear that Pete has returned to visit with all of his friends. So now that you know the story of the snow penguin, hopefully that puts you in the holiday spirit. So from Youngstown State University to you, happy holidays. Did you hear that? Did I miss him? Did you see a penguin walk by? Oh, it was just a car outside. Sorry. Happy holidays. Are you sure that wasn't Pete?